Dear students, today we will discuss the ratio of driving tension for the flat belt drive. Okay, consider a driven pulley rotating in the clockwise direction as shown in the figure 1, figure 2, figure 3 is the free body diagram. Free body diagram. Let capital T1 is the tension in the belt on the tight side. T2 is equal to tension in the belt on the slack side. Theta is equal to angle of contact in radians. Now consider a small portion of the belt PQ subtending at angle delta theta at the center of the pulley. The belt PQ is equilibrium under the following forces. Tension T in the belt at P, tension T plus delta T in the belt at Q, normal reaction Rn and the frictional force F is equal to mu Rn, where mu is the coefficient of friction between the belt and pulley. Resolving all the forces horizontally, we get from the figure 3, Rn minus T into cos 90 minus delta theta by 2 minus T plus delta T cos 90 minus delta theta by 2 is equal to 0. That implies Rn is equal to T into sin delta theta by 2 plus T plus delta T sin delta theta by 2. Since cos 90 minus theta is equal to sin theta. That implies Rn is equal to T into delta theta plus T into delta theta by 2 plus delta T into delta theta by 2. Since delta theta by 2 is a very small, therefore we take an as sin delta theta by 2 as a delta theta by 2. That implies Rn is equal to 2t delta theta by 2 plus delta t into delta theta by 2. Neglecting delta t into delta theta by 2, we get Rn is equal to t plus delta theta. Because delta t is very small and delta theta is very small, then the product of delta t and delta theta is negligible, or that is equivalent to 0. Hence we neglect delta t into delta theta by 2. Now resolving all the forces vertically, we get mu Rn plus T into sin 90 minus delta theta by 2 minus T plus delta T into sin 90 minus delta theta by 2. That implies mu Rn plus T cos delta theta by 2 minus T plus delta T cos delta theta by 2 is equal to 0, because sin 90 minus theta is equal to cos theta. That implies mu Rn plus T minus delta T is equal to 0. Since delta theta is very small and delta theta by 2 is also very small, so we take an as cos delta theta by 2 is equal to 1. T cancel, so mu Rn is equal to delta T. That implies Rn is equal to delta T by mu. This is the equation number 2. From equation 1 and 2, we get T into delta theta is equal to delta T by mu. That implies mu is equal to delta theta is equal to delta t by t. Integrating the above equation between the limits 0 to theta and t2 to t1, we get 0 to theta mu delta theta is equal to t2 to t1 delta t by t is equal to mu theta log base e t1 minus t2 to t2. That is mu theta is equal to log e t1 minus log e t2. That implies mu theta is equal to log base e t1 by t2. That implies t1 by t2 is equal to e to the power mu theta. This is the ratio of driving tension for flat belt drive. Now we will discuss the power transmission by a belt. Okay, let T1 and T2 is equal to tension in the tight side and slack side of the belt respectively in Newton. R1 and R2 is the radii of the driving and driven pulley respectively in meter. V is equal to velocity of the belt in meter per second. The effective turning force at the circumference of the pulley is the difference between the two tension, that is T1 minus T2 in Newton. We know that work done per second is equal to T1 minus T2 into V Newton meter per second. Therefore, power transmitted is equal to T1 minus T2 into V watt. Torque exerted on the driving pulley, T1 minus T2 into R1. Torque exerted on the driven pulley, T1 minus T2 into R2. Thank you. Tomorrow we will discuss some problems, belts, drive. Okay, thank you.